showing you, well, introducing to you a favorite character of mine that you may already know, or not know, if for some of you who may not know. But this is a character that I honestly truly love and I just can't get enough from, and that is the Shocker. Shocker action figures collection, and this was not included in the video because of course I didn't add this figure until I recently found them at my not at my local GameStop but a different GameStop far from my local one, and I couldn't believe it that it was right there just hanging. And I was, and don't get me wrong guys, I was honestly dragging this figure for like, I guess like 2 or 3 months. I honestly didn't want to order it online because it's just, I don't know, I just don't really want to order like newer figures online, so I think it's best just to find it in person. So I did, and I got lucky that I found the Shocker in the hangar. And boy oh boy, let me just say, Shocker, it's just so cool, very retro looking, that, you know, it, I think, I guess it follows, like, the old animated series from Spider-Man. I know many people already reviews this type of figure, but mine's gonna be a bit different. also has one you want to replace a body part into an action figure. They just, I don't know. Is this the right hand? Okay, yeah, it's the right hand. I was just comparing it to my own hand. But now we have Shocker with his right hand with an open fist. His fingers all the way up. It looks really cool. Very, very cool. I like the way he looks. Now, apart from his gauntlets, it also came with amazing just like that. But if you ask me, I know people really don't like seeing these type of effects on Shocker, so I was thinking, why not have an effect like this? Let me put this aside. Wouldn't it be interesting to see a little blast effect from Shocker? So I have this thing, I don't know what exactly it is. I think it's like a something for the hair curls or something. But I said to myself, this looks like a nice little shockwave blast that could potentially go into this figure. I was thinking like you could just connect it here and have it blast this out of his gauntlets. Wouldn't that be so cool, having this type of little blast effect on Shocker? Like he's literally throwing a blast effect at you. Here as if like he's throwing the blast at in the center as if like he's shooting out the blast or something. A little blast effect right there. I don't know if that makes sense, but that'd be so cool though, right? A little blast effect coming out from Shocker. Like that. Or something like it. I never grew up watching that, but I took, you know, I was interested to see what the show offered and, you know, the characters and what's the story like. And the characters themselves, they look pretty cool. Very nice and detailed and colorful. And, you know, apart from that, but it was also, like, futuristic too. Very advanced, like, the technology and everything. It was just mind-blowing. I was like, well, this is, like, the future for, like, a 1994, like, technology was right there, but you know, they didn't build all that stuff later throughout the years. I don't know, that's just me. Anyway, back to the action figures. Shock and Rhino, they did a pretty good team in that one episode where they were trying to take on Spider-Man, but instead they were taken down by Venom. That was pretty funny. Two villains that teamed up to take on Spider-Man. Yeah. Spider-Man would win against Shocker, but you know. Alright, well, that sums up all the figures I have for now to compare with Shocker. What do you guys think about this figure? I know, again, many YouTubers has already covered this figure, and it's been outdated in a way, because there's like no waves coming in. I'm trying to get my hands on that Lizard one from the same wave. Subscribing to